Hey, Dick Rabbit here again.
Hey.
Always get the head cut off. Well, I suppose it's better to get the head cut off. And I'll be able to see what's being worked on. Anyway, now the PC has been installed with the operating system and stuff, and I've been running it for several days and installed a little bit more software, so I think one can close it up with confidence now. So I thought we'd actually go through the closing the case procedure. I think I'll put the back cover on first. Cover off the storage units. That should be just a simple case of putting it in there. Centering the screw and some thumb screw function. Now the next thing is the balsam dust filter with the magnetics rim. I think I'm going to very carefully turn this around, trying not to bump it. And it should go around where the magnets are. Oops. Is that the... No, wait a second. Is this the one for the top? Yeah. Oh, sorry. That's the filter for the top. Let's see. So similar configuration, smaller. Mm-hmm. Oh wait, that's a ledge to fill. Been in storage in the box. Got a bit twisted, so might have actually been better to leave that in place for the installation. Okay, lift it up, and sadly the case got a little bit of dust in it while it's been in the environment I've been working in. It's not the most cleanest. Have to try and live with that. It'll get more dust over time, and then I'll have to clean it anyway. And I wonder if the water matters. All these have magnetic dust filters. Into two notches down there. Wait. Yep, you can still see it in the camera. And now I can do do the most satisfying part is to take the last front glass. I could turn it around a bit. Oh, it's starting to get rather heavy. There, it's quite a good picture, I think. Plastic off. Oops. This is sticky in the back. So, that's done. And that's going to be the top. That's more like these filters are also magnetic, so you can just take them off and clean. That is a really nice case, this. I don't regret buying it. I was also surprised about, as I said in an earlier video, it was actually much cheaper than I thought it would be. Okay, and that's that, and then it's the top. And that's the way it fits. Or actually, if I look at the logic of the... No, because that's close. I didn't check. I think you put it in the hole here. I think that because it's when the flat plate is going to close all the other holes. Okay, so this is the last one to go on. So. Fingerprints all over. Oh, I have to use cleaning liquid gloss cleaner. Clean up the spec after. It's actually, the good thing is that it has very good feet, but The bad thing is that it's hard to move around. Because it's not slippery. But I suppose that's good. It looks and then turn it on. It'll take a while for it to boot up to hit the settings to change the color on the lights, on the fans. It's not a very practical case. Anyway, while that's booting up, then this is the final mechanical stage, at least with this project, and there'll be a few more follow-up videos for the software installation. Actually, I wanted to make a new video about some things that didn't turn out so well in previous videos, and then maybe some extra information about the drivers. Oh, there we go. So let's change that's what it looks like when it's running. Yeah, but anyway, if you found this useful or interesting, remember to subscribe. Hit the bell button if you want to be notified about new videos. Really happy with this, though. And of course, unlimited possibilities for upgrading and modifications. So over the upcoming years, I'll probably be posting some videos about that stuff also. Ryzen 3000 in 1.5 years. always new stuff. Okay, see you in the next one.